Hey guys, Justin with Ready Business Systems. Today I'm going to be showing you how I built this chatbot for our website using ChatGPT. It's not like your usual chatbots. It's way more intelligent. It can give you answers to anything. It has all the power of ChatGPT customized for your website and your company. So it actually talks like a real human. So just to give you an idea here, we have some of these quick quotes we built in to show you how this works, but you can ask this chat bot anything. It looks like a real human. Business hours, how do I schedule a call? It gives a link. It's gonna, you know, I just asked different questions like how many people work there, 20 to 50 dedicated staff. It's not always correct. We have about 18 right now, but I don't even know where it gets this information from, honestly. So it's pretty cool how it's using its ChatGPT brain to really come up with some answers here. When do you recommend seating? It's pulling from here. So this information is coming not only from information that we uploaded to ChatGPT, it's coming from our website, and it's coming from like anywhere over all over the internet. So you can really just ask this thing you can ask this bot anything, and it's going to spit out answers to different questions. So it's super powerful. We're still fine tuning it. It still has some errors, like I noticed right here, snow removal. I'm not sure it got that from maybe some old blog post or something. So we need to make sure we specify in the instructions that we don't do snow removal. So we're still experimenting here, but it's awesome. It's way more powerful than your average chatbot. So let me jump into how we set this up. So we have ChatGPT, and what you do is you got to create a custom GPT is what they call it. You don't have to do it, but it's going to make it more accurate. And I'll show you what I mean. So you click there, you click on my GPTs, and this is what I'm using right now. It's office email responses. I do have an intent to integrate this into our email as well. Haven't gotten there yet, but I'm using the same custom GPT for our chatbot and our website. So they click edit here. I can show you some of the settings. We'll click configure, and you can see here's the name of the custom GPT description, what it does. It gives instructions specifically to the bot. So it's going to say, this is what you're going to do. This is what you're going to write. This is what it's used for. How do I handle appointments? Just some specific instructions. This is also where I would modify, put in special instructions if it's not answering right. For example, we do not perform snow removal. That's something I'll probably update here. You also have the ability to update what they call knowledge here. So these are a bunch of files. I sent a bunch of sent emails, documents, internal like the company handbook, the welcome email to customers, a whole bunch of information just to provide with something that it might not already be on the internet. So you go to that is we go to what they call it's the assistance playground. This is how you use APIs. The API is what enables this chatbot to actually work. And set up a little bit separately. You do have to pay. It's very inexpensive for what we're using it for, but you do have to pay to use it on your website for anything using the ChatGPT API. So we have what they call the assistant. We set this up on the model. I'm using 4.0. This is like the latest version of ChatGPT, the most intelligent. It costs a little bit more to use. Again, it's kind of not a significant amount of money at all. During all this testing, I've used like 50 cents of credits. And we have these other models. Some of them are less accurate, but they respond a little faster. I don't really care how long it takes. It's fast enough for me. And I kind of like that it takes a minute to process because it looks like there's a real human behind the chatbot. Right here, we have file search. This is where we upload those same files. So we just have a little bit of more information for this bot. So in here in these instructions, this is where we'd also say things like, you know, we don't do the snow removal. We'd add them in here. Instructed to be fun, friendly, make jokes, don't give any exact numbers for pricing because I found it was spitting out some numbers that weren't correct. So then what I did is once I did this, you can get an API, which is in the dashboard here. I don't want to dig into that at the moment, but you'll find an API you can generate is what we need to get these bots set up. So after trying a couple different versions of chatbots, I landed on this one called Open Widget. And this is the back end here where you do all your setup. So I added in a couple of, here's our actual chats here. I added in a couple questions. I don't want it to email us. I want it to use only the bots. So I kind of disabled a lot of these different options here just to make it work. And then it's going to spit out code for you to put in your website. So I'm pretty happy with this. I think it's super cool. The other thing we're doing is we set up an AI call answering as well. And I'll get into that in a second video. But if you guys have any questions, feel free to comment here and I'll answer them as best I can. If necessary, I can make another video for you. But this stuff is super cool. It's next level. In my opinion, I think that anyone using this AI technology is going to be more profitable until, of course, everyone uses it, you know, years down the road, you're probably not gonna be able to stay in business without it. So in the meantime, I think you're saving money that other people aren't. You can afford cheaper prices, or you can have a higher profit margin just because you're an early adapter of this technology. So feel free to reach out or check out our website, readybusinesssystems.com. Thanks for watching.